Hello all, let us now talk about maintenance. What is maintenance? Maintenance is basically a terminology used in any field to make sure that something which is not in order is fixed, or a process that is taken to make sure that things don't break down. Even in the monitoring perspective also, we have something called as a maintenance, which is basically to stop or arrest the unwanted alerts triggering in the system. In every environment, it could be servers or websites or database or whatsoever, we would be monitoring, and be it a bug fix or a software installation or any database maintenance or a website maintenance, a lot of alerts would be triggered during this time. To avoid that, we use something called maintenance, which is basically going to completely stop the alerting during this time. So how do we go about creating a maintenance in Zabbix? In the left, we can see the configuration pane. Click on the maintenance tab. Here, we have to click on create maintenance period in the top right corner. Once that is done, we get an option to write the name. So it is a good practice to write what is the change about. And usually in every environment, there will be ITIL process followed, and accordingly a change task will be created. So let us give, for example, CH123456 as the change task, which is for the reboot of one particular server after doing small changes on a machine. So all those things will be handled in the change request. For the monitoring, it is only to disable the alerts during this time. The option that we can see here is with data collection or no data collection. Basically, with data collection, is all it's going to do is it is going to stop the alert in both the cases, but with data collection, it is going to keep on collecting the data at the frequency at which a particular server or service is being monitored in the back end for the graphing purpose. But when we do a no data collection, it doesn't collect any data. It totally blankets itself out whenever we put it into maintenance. So the next option is the active since and active till. Say for example, we want to do this maintenance just one time, and we're going to put a small time or a longer time is 26 to 27, just one complete day. So let us leave it as it is. In the description, we're gonna write the change task is to fix DB issue and reboot the machine data. Should we put the server name from 5:30 a.m. to 6:30 a.m. on 26th. Just an indication. So let's go to the period. Here we click on add period. We can add more than one period. So for now, for the sake of understanding, let's keep it one time. And this is on 26th. So let's take it as 5:30 in the morning. And then it is just for 1 hour, or you can say a number of days or hours and minutes. So let us keep it as 1 hour. Click on add. You can add more than one interval. So within a day, if it's going to be rebooted 3 times, we can put all the times here. And whenever there is no maintenance period, it'll come out of the maintenance window. Next, going to the host and host group. Here we can put either the host group, which is the group of the servers which is going to maintenance, or hosts. More than one host can also be part of the maintenance. They may not be belonging to host group, or we can use both. I can put all the servers which is in America server group, plus I can put which server is these two servers into maintenance also. So all the hosts which are in America server group and these two servers will go into maintenance. For now, let us remove the America servers, and I'm just going to use these two servers, and then I just click on add. That's it. So it is going to give information like this. Putting up the description is more important so that we can understand what is happening. And the active since and active till, making it a closed window, is going to help us achieve it better. Though the one which is more important is the time that we are going to give inside the monitoring. Okay, let us create a recurring maintenance. So same, click on create maintenance period. I give it as ch like this, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I don't want any data collection. This is a weekly reboot, and I'm going to give 26th of this month till 23rd of next year, October. I'm going to put a description as weekly reboot, weekly service restart. No, service, restart, not the reboot. Okay, I'm gonna put the period as weekly on every Saturday at say 22 hours in the night. So 10 o'clock in the night on every Saturday it's gonna happen, and it's gonna happen for just 30 minutes. I'm not gonna put any hours. It's just 30 minutes. That is good enough. Okay, I'm gonna click on host group, and I'm gonna put the server as this one. So this particular server is gonna go into a maintenance on every Saturday at 10 p.m. for 30 minutes, and this maintenance window is active from 26th of this month to 23rd of October next year, which means that every Saturday beginning from 26th of October, every Saturday 10 p.m. for 30 minutes, this particular host will be into maintenance. And this is how it looks. We can give more description, more better meaning to the description, so that it conveys a clear message as to what it is. Because as in when we progress, too many maintenance windows get created, and you should not clutter in understanding what is happening where and when and on which server. Another important thing is that when we create the maintenance, it shows the status active whenever it completes or it is ended. It moves out of this active, and whenever it is about to begin, it is going to say it's about to begin, and when it is in progress, it says it is in progress, and when it is complete, it's completed. So there's different states that it gives up to understand or to make us understand that there are different stages of the maintenance. So in case of a repetitive cyclic maintenance like the first one, it's going to keep on changing its states from active to about to begin to in progress to completed to active and henceforth. And whenever we are done with the one-time maintenance windows, it is good to delete them. Just click on this. Once it is complete, they click on delete. So it just declutters our maintenance windows. That's it. We can also use a lot of filters here to make sure that we have the active one, the approaching one, and the expired ones. And with this, we can understand things better. And we can just select all the expired ones and then delete them in one shot. And approaching, we can understand what is the next schedule that's going to happen. Suppose we have to do some restart with these on the Zabbix server itself. In that case, all these maintenance windows helps us a lot. More videos in the next. Cheers.